We have another big running back contract. Christian McCaffrey signed a 4-year, $64 million contract extension with the Panthers on April 16th. Or was that the day before? Whatever day it was. The news came out yesterday. McCaffrey will now be under contract until 2025. It's another big running back contract. As everyone knows, running back contracts, veteran running back contracts, are one of the most controversial signings in the NFL. The analytics community, the cap community, everybody is essentially against paying a running back a lot of money. Why? Because running back is an easily replaceable position that is heavily reliant on offensive line play. Meaning, if you are going to spend money, it's a better place to invest in the offensive line or somewhere else on your offense or on the rest of your team rather than the running back because of his heavy reliance on other factors, factors outside his control, coupled with the fact that the age curve for the running back position, you know, for a long time we've said that running backs don't make it to 30 or they fall off at 30. The reality is that running backs are really falling off more along the lines of like 27, 28, depending on workload, factors like that. It's not a great reality, and it's really unfortunate because I think running backs are important to team success, but all of their value is early in their career. It's when they're not making any money. Therefore, when it comes time to pay them, it's not a good investment. But Christian McCaffrey represents a special case. But then again, we could have also said the same thing about Todd Gurley heading into that new contract after he had 788 yards receiving in 2017. Now, there's a very important piece of this with Christian McCaffrey that I think exceeds the Todd Gurley situation because I think he had somewhere around 65 catches in 2017. Christian McCaffrey had 116 catches and 105 yards receiving last year. Now, receiving running backs, they age very well. So I'm under the impression that Christian McCaffrey, now 24 years old, will age well throughout this contract. The reality of this situation, though, for the Panthers is terrific. They can get out of the deal. Maybe it's not terrific, but they can get out of the deal essentially at 27 years old. He's 24 now with $8.6 million in dead money and $7.7 million in cap savings. The next year, it's $4.3 million in dead money and $12 million in cap savings. So we're looking at a scenario where they can get out of the deal in his 28-year-old season. They're also in a scenario where Teddy Bridgewater is their quarterback. Maybe there's a potential that they go try and find another quarterback, but Teddy's the guy. And now considering this, they have a relatively low-cost quarterback when you consider the veteran market. So the hope is that Teddy Bridgewater will produce for them at a decent level. And Christian McCaffrey is now one of the he's the face of the franchise. He's a great receiver, and he's one of the few expensive salary cap hits that they'll have in the coming years that they're tied into. So there's not going to be a lot of heavy spending around him. And there's a really important factor that we see with Joe Brady being the offensive coordinator. He won't be running Christian McCaffrey into loaded boxes. He's intelligent. The percentage of carries with 8-plus men in the box for some notable running backs in the 2020 class, according to Graham Barfield, Clyde Edwards-Helaire, 6% of his carries were into these loaded boxes. By comparison, A.J. Dillon for BC, which really might give you an understanding of either the lack of quarterback play at Boston College or just the general lack of intelligence of the offensive coordinator. Maybe it's both. And it also speaks to Jonathan Taylor, 29% of loaded boxes. But the point being, he's going to avoid throwing C-Mac into loaded boxes. Now, there's one other factor that's very interesting here regarding Helaire, is that I don't have it in front of me, but he had Clyde Edwards-Helaire stats. I believe he had 55 catches last year or something crazy. Yeah, he had 55 catches, which I believe was 20 more catches than the next highest SEC running back. Some crazy number. But essentially speaking, we've got an offensive coordinator that is going to use Christian McCaffrey well. He is 24 years old. He doesn't have a rich injury history. But the reality of this scenario, the reality of this contract, the important thing to remember is that if Christian McCaffrey does not work out, there's a really high probability that we should really essentially never again see a big second contract running back in this kind of, in the current market as it stands. The market will completely adjust down as it should if Christian McCaffrey is another data point that says that paying running backs is just not a good idea. even if they produce exceptionally well receiving. But I also side a little bit with Scott Barrett. Scott Barrett from Pro Football Focus. I believe he just left. He's got his own things on the horizon. Keep an eye out for Scott. But he has noted that there is a heavy correlation between year-to-year production of high-performing running backs, which is something that you do want to invest in, similar to a tight end. It's a really good mismatch. It's someone you can get out in the open field. Christian McCaffrey, for a variety of reasons, I don't look at this contract as negatively as I would normally look at a running back contract. And I have a lot of confidence in Christian McCaffrey holding value from 2020 through potentially 2024 when he's 28 years old. Now, is he going to be worth $6.3 million against his cap? Against the cap? I don't know. If coronavirus in the pandemic, which is now subsiding, which now data is coming out, I know this is going to upset some people that we're not all going to die, but some data has come out that has readjusted based on antibody tests, has readjusted down, and the death rate will essentially be at flu-like levels. We are ready to get back to work. America's ready to get going again. So the hope is that we can get the economy moving again. We can get the TV deals in place for the NFL. And next year's salary cap will not be severely impacted by what has gone on over the last month. Whatever you may think of it, I have plenty of thoughts, as many of you follow me on Twitter know. No matter what has gone on the last month, we are in a position where the NFL, if things work out as we've projected, we could see $20, $30, $40 million increase in the salary cap next year based on TV contracts. Now, we have to get past the fear. We have to get past the fear mongering. And we have to get back to doing this, or else the next year's cap might be severely impacted. So the reality of the markets coming up is if the cap increases by a large jump, we are going to be in a position where this $16 million a year contract for Christian McCaffrey is not as crazy as you consider. And here's one more thing I want people to consider in terms of 2019 receiving lines. Christian McCaffrey had those 116 receptions, 1,005 yards receiving, 4 touchdowns on 142 targets, 82% catch rate, 8.7 yards per catch, 7.3 yards per target. Amari Cooper, who is now, he's 2 years older than McCaffrey and a wide receiver, another position that does not age extremely well, 79 receptions, 1,189 yards, 8 touchdowns on 119 targets, 66% catch rate, 15.1 yards per catch, huge difference, almost double, 10 yards per target. They do two different things. Cooper is providing you the more consistent big play in the passing game, the chunk play, the larger chunk. But Christian McCaffrey is also averaging an 82% catch rate, 7.3 yards per target. So 7.3 yards per play when you throw him the football on top of what he does as a rusher. And he had 1,387 rushing yards last year with 15 touchdowns. His extension will cost $4 million per year less than Amari Cooper's. Now, and also, both of them, both the Cowboys structured the deal in a way that's going to allow them to get out of the Cooper deal in relatively short order, as most contracts today are, really outside of wide quarterback. But quarterback is also a very stable position. Once you invest in that guy, you know you're probably going to try and keep him. But anyway, we're looking at a guy who produced over 2,000 yards last year, total yards. He's an incredible threat, had almost 20 touchdowns. Do I think we're looking at another scenario like Todd Gurley? I think there's a higher probability of success for Christian McCaffrey. I do know that Todd Gurley's knee is a mess. The rumors about arthritis may very well be true, which again opens up a conversation about college and about the damage that players are forced to undertake with no money for degrees that don't matter. Your communications degree, like mine, doesn't matter. Your sociology degree doesn't matter compared to the amount of money that you produce for an organization like Georgia football. So putting this all together, Christian McCaffrey, very interesting signing, very interesting case study that's going to could change how we perceive things. I think we're looking at a guy who could really reshape how we perceive the market. If we're only talking about, these exceptional receiving running backs. So it's just a new data point, but if it doesn't work out, it's sayonara. We're done with running back, large running back investments, and we have to continue to stay on the tip of expressing the value of running backs and rookie contracts and how dangerous it is that rookie contracts are 4 or 5 years when we talk about player earnings, and that's one major thing. I'm glad the CBA has been signed considering the coronavirus stuff going on, but understand that the CBA's largest issue was not addressed, which is, in my opinion, largest issue, and this is my soapbox, but players go to college, don't get paid. Then they get drafted by organizations. They get to take advantage of a free minor league. And then on their rookie contract, they're told, oh, well, we can't pay you. You know, we have slotted rookie contracts and we can't renegotiate an extension until after 3 years. And, you know, you're locked into at least 4 years. And then, hey, we could franchise tag you. And thank you, Le'Veon Bell, because you've put every organization under the threat that a player who does not who is not treated fairly in terms of just, you know, it, or feels he's not treated fairly will sit out, which is what's forcing organizations like the Cowboys and like the Panthers to go out and sign these running backs like Ezekiel Elliott and Christian McCaffrey. And hey, that's my alpha brain, girl. Don't you steal that, girl? All right, sorry. like Christian McCaffrey, because they don't want to play the double franchise tag game with a very vital piece of their organization. And so he did a great service. And what we're saying now, too, is, again, about that CBA issue. The real issue with this CBA, you have to be allowed to renegotiate contracts after your second season, because you know every organization by the second year knows many of these players that are the big money guys, are going to be big money guys. Or, you know, it's just the player needs the opportunity to earn what he's worth. And that is a major issue, a major sticking point that I have with the CBA, and something that continues to need to be addressed. And, you know, people are talking about continuing to address the CBA as these years go on. That sounds great. I don't think it's going to happen. But by 2030, we need to get this through our heads and realize that the economic reality that we are going to look at in 2030 is that, yes, the league minimum will be $1 million, essentially. But quarterbacks may be making $60 million. So we're going to be looking at, like, you know, remember those graphs after Wall Street crashed and all the CEOs were making tons of money? And then you had, like, the average worker. The CEO makes 37 times the average worker, whatever. We're looking at a similar scenario in the NFL. And the CEO in this scenario is the quarterback, although the real CEO or the organizations that make $30 million a year, then profit, and they profit $30 million a year, and then they increase their valuation by billions of dollars. Even if they're the Jaguars and they suck as an organization, and their owner and essentially has no idea what he's doing from an analytics perspective, other than, hey, I want to move to London. So a lot of dirt there if you want to look into it on the Khan family. But anyway, moving on, Christian McCaffrey signing out. Hope y'all are well, and let's get back to normal. God bless.